morning students. Hope you all are fine. In my previous lecture, we have discussed about social ecology. We have understood what is the meaning of social ecology and what is the aim of social ecology. In my video class or the live class, we have discussed about the socialist ecology. That means we had read about the contribution of Marx towards the development of the social ecology. According to Marx, he said that we have to believe in socialism, rather he was a believer of communism. According to him, the producers class, that means the worker class, has a right to shape the nature. And you know, while doing shaping the nature, the person or the worker class is highly influenced by it. So that is why, according to Marxism or according to the Marx environmentalistic view, he said that we have to overthrow capitalism and we have to believe in the concept of equality. And when once we believe in the equality, then only we can develop those knowledge and we can attain that knowledge by which we can sustain our environment and as well as the inhabitants. And we have to give equal rights to each and every human as well as non-human world. So this was all about the socialist ecology. Today I will start with ecofeminism. Ecofeminism, it consists of two words. Eco means ecology. Feminism, that means feminist. That means we are talking about women. Now see, according to this movement, which was born out of feminist peace and ecology in late 1970s and in the early 1980s, the term was used by Françoise Yvon. According to ecofeminism, it shows an interconnection between ecology and woman nature. Now, both are, you know, like men, if I say that there is an equality, though there is no equality, the nature is dominated by men and as well as the women are oppressed by men. So these two theories, when it comes together, we call it as ecofeminism. So ecofeminism, again, it's a movement, I said, it comes out of the feminist peace and ecology, peace movement. In this ecofeminism, it says that we have to take up those philosophies and those ideology by which we can, you know, like reduce or we can remove the domination of nature or oppression of the woman. So because, you know, like the ecofeminist agrees that domination of women and domination of nature are fundamentally connected. And we all know that women are directly connected with the nature. So once the nature is dominated, that means, you know, there is oppression of the women that is seen all over the world. So they do not seek equality with men as such, but aim for liberation of women as women. So women should not be considered as a property or as a, you know, like a human that whose only values lies like during the childbirth and nursery. Beside that, woman plays a very important role in, you know, like in the in taking care of the nature. So the relationship of the exploitative dominance between men and nature and exploitative and oppressive relationship between men and women are seen closely connected. So ecofeminism believes that patriarchal society, we all are in patriarchal society, that have four interlocking pillars, sexism, racism, class exploitation, and environmental destruction. I said just now that we have seen also that women are largely responsible for, you know, in the, you know, many fields you have seen the women are working for all day and night, and the men owe the land. Okay. So this practice has to be omitted if we want to have a, you know, like a thinking in a deep ecology point of view. So until and unless we think in this direction that we, if you want to uplift our environment, then we have to maintain that equality. There should not be any gender biasness between men and women. Then only we can have a thinking of deep ecology. So last paragraph is saying that comparing women to nature, we can say that man exploit the natural environment in the same way as they exploit the woman's labor on land. And both women and environment are marginalized within the economy. Not only are nature and women used as exploitable resources by men, but they are grossly undervalued. That is very true. It is believed that women in developing countries are dependent on nature for survival, and so destruction of environment would definitely affect the condition of women. Ecofeminists claim to be a part of social movement, the ideology which is spelled out in the book Reviving the World, the Emergence of Ecofeminism by Diamond Orenstein. Ecofeminism is a movement that focuses attention on the historical linkage between the denigration of nature and the females. That means there is an unfairly way or unfair criticism towards the nature and the females. So this was the, you know, like the attention in ecofeminism movement, that we have to omit this racism, classism, ageism, and ethnosexism, and exploitation of nature to recognition to naturalism is also a result of the logic. Politically, ecofeminists work on a broad range of issues to halt all destructive policies and practices, and seeks to create alternative rooted in community-based legitimacy that gives due respect and recognition of the value of both women and men. The work consists of resistance, creativity, and hope. However, ecofeminism doesn't work. You know, it is just written in the book. It is still prevailing in our country, even in some parts of the world also. So it is only given in some of the books, or it is written, you know, like some of the papers. It is just an ecological thought that embodies consciousness rising, healing, and communication with the nature. So, you know, like after ecofeminism, we come to the discussion with green politics. Now, green politics means what? That means the politics where it is, you know, like involved with the greenery, that means with the environment. That is why it is given that green politics that aims for the creation of the ecological sustainable society rooted in environmentalism, social liberalism, and grassroots ecosystem. That means we have to think from the grassroots level that how each and every person's decision is, you know, like very important in terms of politics. And in this way, if you take each and every opinion in framing politics, and if the belief that we are, you know, like can protect our environment, that means that is called as a green politics. So green politics in Germany and England, green politics was created in Germany, with United Tasmania Group, founded in Australia in 1972. A year later, Europe launched its first Green Party, UK Ecology Party. The German Green Party was not one of the first, but they attracted media attention and came into lifeline. The German Greens stood for election in 1980, 1983, federal election, the Greens won 27 seats from Bundestag. The first European Green Party to come into power at state level was the Green League from Finland in 1995. These all are the years which you have to learn for your objective question. The Green German Greens were the next forming government with the Social Democratic Party of Germany. They were in power from 1998 to 2005. In Latvia, Indulis Emises became the first prime minister of Latvia for 10 months. In the state of Baden-Württemberg, the Green Party is a leader of coalition with Social Democrats in the state election in 2011. The practice of describing green philosophy via four pillars began with the German Green Party in 1970 to 1980. And the four pillars were ecological wisdom, social justice, and grassroots democracy and non-violence. So we will discuss the meaning of this, all four roots of the green politics. These are the important question for your exam, that what are the four pillars of green politics? So these are ecological wisdom. That means we have to think about the environment. We have to reduce the negative impact of human being onto the natural environment. Social justice means that it is a justice for all over the people. That means there will be no casteism, no sexism, no racism. All culture will get the equal justice. There will be, you know, that what we call it as a universally accepted law. Grassroots democracy means the, like we have read in the Panchayat Samiti, that, you know, like the local people handle each and every issues. That is called as a, you know, like the Panchayat. You have heard about the Panchayat Raj. So that means grassroots democracy, participatory democracy is embraced by green, only the reliable governance model for achieving social change. non-violence, everything definitely comes out of peace movement. So there should be a term non-violence. Okay. So next class, we will continue with the topic that is the sustainable development, and along with the how green revolution, how green politics started in Egypt. Thank you.